Hi, my name is Rahul and welcome to my YouTube channel. A common challenge when building cloud applications is how to manage credentials in your code for authenticating to cloud services. Keeping credentials secure is an important task. You do not want to push them into your source control. The Managed Identities for Azure Resources feature in Active Directory solves this problem. The feature provides Azure services with a managed identity in Azure AD. It can be used to authenticate with any resource that supports Azure AD authentication. In this video, let's look at how to set up your local environment to connect with managed service identity. In the previous video, we had looked at default Azure credential, which is a way to unify and connect with the Azure AD application. Let's look at how to configure default Azure credential for your local development environment so that it can connect seamlessly as with MSI when deployed in Azure. There are two ways you can configure your local environment to connect to the Azure AD application when running on your local environment. The first one is to use environment variables and to specify a set of values which will be used by default Azure credential. The second is to use the IDE's token cache credential to connect with the Azure resources. To set the environment variables, we need to set the Azure client ID, tenant ID, and the client secret. Let's look at where we can get these values from. Going to the Azure portal, let's create a new Azure AD under the app registrations in your Azure Active Directory tab. Let's click New Registration and call this Local Development Environment. I'll leave the rest by default and click Register. Once created, you get the client ID and the tenant ID for the application. To get the secret, let's create a new client secret under Certificates and Secrets. You can select for 1 year or two or never. Let's call this for dev environment and say add. Make sure to keep a copy of this value, which we will use shortly. Let's head to Visual Studio, where I have code set up to hit the Graph API using the default Azure credential and get the Active Directory groups. In Configure Services, let's set up the environment variables. We could either set up the environment variables in code here so that each developer doesn't have to repeat this, or you can set it up in the environment variables in Windows. For that, you can go to Edit Environment Variables and add them for the specified keys here. However, if you set it up inside code, each developer of your team doesn't have to repeat this step. I have an MSI environment class which has the tenant ID, client ID, and secret ID created. This will be mapped to the app settings which has the similar values set up here. Let's look at how we can set this up from the configure services method. We want to be able to run this only when it's in the debug mode. So let's add the #if debug check before the code. Using the configuration that's injected into the startup class, we can bind the MSI environment node from the config to this object here. Once we have that, we should have all the values that's specified in the config file. We just use the environment.setEnvironment variable to set the different keys as shown here. Heading back, we do not want to set the values here because this is going to be checked into the source control. So let's right-click on the solution and say Manage User Secrets, where you can override these values in the appsettings.json. So let's copy this node and paste it into the secrets.json. Now we can modify these values. Let's get the client ID. Let's put in the tenant ID and the client secret that we copied before. With all those values set, let's run this application to see if this works as expected. Let's put a breakpoint here to see exactly what's happening. Let's step through the code. The configuration is getting bound, so let's make sure the values are coming here and the environment variables are set as expected. Let's check the Get Graph API client, which uses the default Azure credential to authenticate with Azure AD. It makes the Get Token async call and we are successfully able to get the token back. With that token, we can hit the Graph API client and get all the groups that's part of the AD. This does say we have an insufficient privileges. To solve this problem, let's head back to the portal and make sure we grant permissions to the Azure AD app talk to the Graph API. So even though these permissions are here, we need to grant the admin consent for the default directory. Once that is granted, let's restart the application And you can see it's setting the environment variables, getting the Graph API client, and it gets back all the AD groups from my Azure AD. The next approach is use the IDE's token cache credential. So let's remove this code and look at how to use the Azure AD's token credential. Under Tools, in Options, there is an option for Azure Service Authentication, where it uses the account to authenticate with the AD. Make sure you have an explicit user in your Azure AD and use that here. When I was using my Microsoft account to connect, this did not work with default Azure credential. So I have created a new user in the Active Directory and added this in here. I have the same code, however, I don't have any environment variables set now. So using default Azure credential, it will use the Visual Studio's token cache credential to connect to AD and retrieve the groups. Let's see if that works by default. It gets the Graph API client, and you can see all the AD groups are retrieved back as expected. The downside of this method is that if you have lots of people in your team, you will have to add each of them and give them permissions for whatever resources that you have. Since this is Graph API, they had default permissions. However, if it's a specific resource like Key Vault or a SQL Server, you might need to explicitly add them in. Hope this helps you to get started with default Azure credential and getting it set up on your local development environment. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to be notified of future such videos, please subscribe. Thank you.